the Bin Laden raid was carried out actually under CIA authority.
You had this is what you're talking about, sheep dipping, right?
Yeah, okay. Right. So there's this, what happens is, when we talked about the early period where the Pentagon and the CIA were fighting for several years, and they got together around 2005 and 2006, and they basically said, we've got to work out some rules here. And so there was this the series of arrangements that got worked out where they basically carved up the world by country. So a place like Pakistan, they said, okay, the CIA is going to be in charge in Pakistan. If there's military involvement, if there's cross-border raids from Afghanistan, it's going to be under CIA authority. And what happened was they basically would instantly turn people into CIA operatives overnight. They call it the term sheep dipping. It's a bureaucratic flick of a switch that you are operating under CIA authority. So the most famous example of this is May of 2011, when teams of Navy SEALs got into helicopters, went from Afghanistan into Pakistan, killed Osama bin Laden, and the entire time they were under the authority of the CIA, because only the CIA is authorized to operate in Pakistan. Now, one could ask, if that operation had gone terribly wrong, and if the SEALs had been captured or killed, the United States would not have been able to deny that operation.
Right.
But this at least gave a fig leaf in order to carry it out in a deniable way and not inform the government of Pakistan that they were doing it.
So maybe, really quickly, how did they divide the world up? I mean, what were the considerations? Presumably there were really political considerations and some legal considerations related to that.
That's right. So it would be dependent on the individual sensitivities in a country for having American troops. So, for instance, Pakistan is Pakistan is so vehemently against the idea of American troops in its borders. So CIA was going to be in charge, and Pakistan's government always insisted that anything the United States did had to be denied. In other words, you do a drone strike, Pakistan takes credit for it. It's not an American drone strike. So Pakistan was an easy one. It was going to be under CIA control. Other countries, though, had more a greater willingness to have American troops. So, for instance, the Philippines had a Navy SEAL presence, so the military could operate more openly and sort of be in charge more, as opposed to the CIA having authority. So it depended on what the country's government's disposition was to having American operations, the nature of what they were doing, and who could handle which country at any given time. Toward the end of the book, I talk about how Yemen really became the Pentagon's war, in part because the CIA was so focused on Pakistan. And only after they had done enough in Pakistan and there was the threat in Yemen started to rise, the CIA built a base in Saudi Arabia to do drone strikes in Yemen, and both the CIA and the Pentagon were doing drone wars
Yemen. Drone wars, right.
Yeah.
Okay.
So it's even 11 years later, it hasn't all been worked out, and they're still trying to work out a lot of the rules for this war.